Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss how to build decision trees using a dataset. This video is a part of Introduction to Classification series. So if you want to refer the playlist, I will provide the link in the description. A decision tree is a popular and powerful method for making predictions in data science. Its popularity is due to simplicity of the technique, making it easy to understand. Now let's have a look at our dataset which we will use to build a decision tree. This data is about a set of patients, all of whom suffered from the same illness. During their course of treatment, each patient responded to one of two medications. We call them drug A and B. Using this dataset, we are going to build a decision tree which helps us to predict disease when a new patient appears. Before building the decision tree, let's have a look at the two popular attribute selection measures required for building a decision tree. What is entropy? In the layman words, it is nothing just the measure of disorder or measure of purity. Basically, it is a measurement of the impurity or randomness in the data points. Entropy is calculated between 0 and 1. Although depending upon the number of groups or classes present in the dataset, it could be larger than 1, but it signifies the same meaning, that is, higher level of disorder. A high order of disorder means a low level of impurity. Information gain. The concept of entropy plays an important role in calculating information gain. Information gain is applied to quantify which feature provides maximal information about the classification based on the notion of entropy. That is, by quantifying the size of uncertainty, disorder, or impurity. Information gain equals to entropy before split minus entropy after split. Gini index. Gini index, also known as Gini impurity, calculates the amount of probability of a specific feature that is classified incorrectly when selected randomly. If all the elements are linked with a single class, then it can be called pure. Gini index varies between values 0 and 1. When 0 expresses the purity of classification, that is, all the elements belong to a specified class or only one class existed, and 1 indicates the random distribution of elements across various classes. The value of 0.5 of the Gini index shows an equal distribution of elements over some classes. While designing the decision tree, the features possessing the least value of the Gini index would get preferred. The Gini index is determined by deducting the sum of squared of probabilities of each class. This is the Gini index formulae, where Pi denotes the probability of an element being classified for a distinct class. The Gini index facilitates the bigger distributions, so easy to implement, whereas the information gain favors lesser distributions, having small count with multiple specific values. The method of Gini index is used by CART algorithms. In contrast to it, information gain is used in ID3C4.5 algorithms. Gini index and information gain are used for the analysis of the real-time scenario, but today we are going to use information gain. In the next video, we will use Gini index. Building decision tree. Decision trees are built using recursive partitioning to classify the data. Let's say we have 14 patients in our data set. The algorithm chooses the most predictive feature to split the data on. What is important in making a decision tree is to determine which attribute is the best or more predictive to split data based on the feature. Let's say we pick cholesterol as the first attribute to split data. It will split our data into two branches. As you can see, if the patient has high cholesterol, we cannot say with high confidence that drug B might be suitable for him. Also, if the patient's cholesterol is normal, we still don't have sufficient evidence or information to determine if either drug A or B is in fact suitable. It is a sample of bad attribute selection for splitting data. So let's try another attribute. Again, we have our 14 cases. This time we pick up the gender attribute of patient. It will split our data into two branches, male and female. As you can see, if the patient is male, we can say drug B might be suitable for him with high certainty. But if the patient is female, we don't have sufficient evidence or information to determine if drug A or B is suitable. Now I have two questions for you. 1. How to measure the impurity present in the notes? 2. Between the cholesterol and gender attributes, which one is a better choice? Pause the video and think about it. To measure the impurity, we need to find entropy of each node. As we discussed above, entropy is used to calculate the homogeneity of the sample. You can easily calculate the entropy of a node using the frequency table of the attribute through the entropy formula, where P is the proportion or ratio of a category such as drug A or B. Now let's try to calculate the entropy of a dataset before splitting it. We have 8 occurrences of drug B and 6 of drug A. You can embed these numbers into the entropy formula to calculate the impurity of the target attribute before splitting it. In this case, it is 0.98. So what is entropy after splitting? Let's first select the cholesterol of the patient and see how the data gets split based on its values. We can calculate the entropy of this node based on the distribution of drug A and B, which is 0.87 and 0.99 in this case. If we choose the gender attribute for the next check, the entropy for this node is 0.65, which is not very promising. However, on the other side of the branch, the entropy is 0.9. Now the second question arises, between the cholesterol and gender attributes, which one is a better choice? Or in which state do we have less entropy after splitting data than before splitting? The answer is the tree with the higher information gain after splitting. As we discussed earlier, information gain is the entropy of a tree before the split minus the weighted entropy after the split by an attribute. We can think of information gain and entropy as opposites. As entropy or the amount of randomness decreases, the information gain or amount of certainty increases and vice versa. Now let's calculate the information gain of gender attribute. The entropy of the tree before the split is 0.98. The portion of the female patients is 9 out of 14 and its entropy is 0.9. Also, the portion of men is 6 out of 14 and the entropy of male node is 0.65. The result of square bracket here is the weighted entropy after the split. So the information gain of the tree if we use the gender attribute to split the dataset is 0.122. We can calculate the information gain of the tree if we use cholesterol as well, it is 0.05. So as mentioned, the tree with the higher information gain after splitting is best suitable. This means the gender attribute. Now what is the next attribute after branching by gender attribute? Well, as you can guess, we should repeat the process for each branch and test each of the other attributes to continue to reach the most pure layers. This is the way you build a decision tree. Thanks for watching.